2-1 Correspondence. Interesting Examples Part 1.
So children, in the previous video you have learned what are pairs of objects.
How to make a pair of two identical objects. And this process of making pairs of the objects is called 1-to-1 correspondence. And in this video, we will see some more examples of 1-to-1 correspondence in which we will create pairs of two objects used in the same task. Today is Chotu's cricket class. He can't find his bat and ball. He asks his mother for help.
Mom, do you know where my bat and my ball are kept?
Yes, Chotu, they are on the chair. In a hurry, you forgot that you had placed them on this chair.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Mom.
Your pair of star socks looks very good.
Thank you, Mom.
Do you know that just like these socks are in a pair, your bat and ball are also in a pair?
But how, Mom? These socks look the same and I wear them together. That's why they are in pairs. How are these bat and ball in pair?
I will explain it to you, son. You use the bat and the ball together while playing cricket, don't you?
Yes, Mom.
That means two objects which are used together in a task can also be called a pair.
Oh, really? Can you tell me more examples of such pairs?
Yes, why not, son? Look at the paper and pen placed on that table. We use both these things in writing, which means...
This means pen and paper also form a pair.
Yes, Chotu, you are absolutely correct. Now, can you tell me examples of more such pairs?
Pant and shirt?
Yes, Chotu. Pant and shirt are also a pair. But Chotu, can you tell me that how these two are also in a pair?
Yes, we wear pant and shirt together. So both of them are in a pair. Isn't it, Mom?
Yes, Chotu. Very good. Come on now, quickly get ready for your class. Otherwise, you will get late.
Children, can you also identify such pairs around you? That was all for today's lesson. In this video, we learned how to make pairs of two objects which are used together in the same task. In the next video, we will look at another interesting example. Until then, goodbye, friends!